Right, ladies and gentlemen, you can see a bit of a triangle going on there. Well, I have a gentleman here. We will see him in a bit, from a company called LaserWorld. He is the UK representative for LaserWorld, and he has brought some goodies for us to look at. You'll also notice the window. Now, the window's got a load of light coming through it, which means it's broad daylight outside, which means that you're looking at a laser that is exceedingly powerful and is cutting through, there you go, it's cutting through the light in the room and also the light from outside. So as the night progresses, it's going to get slightly darker, which means we'll get more of an effect. The whole idea of showing you this is to show you how powerful these lasers are, literally in broad daylight. And this is what we're going to be looking at. Not the beer. We finish off with some bad boys. Right, there we go. That's a nice little unit. And that chap over there is a guy by the name of Dennis Phoenix. Saw him in a video you should have done in Frankfurt Music Messe. Dennis, my friend, what is this little number here?
This little unit is one of the starting price point or starting point of lasers within LaserWorld's range. One thing we discussed was to really show that LaserWorld aren't just about stadium type lasers or lasers that are for big events, for high sort of end professional gigs, but they have lasers right through the range that start as little as £69 retail, or even sort of cheaper online in certain places.
Yeah.
You'll see this little unit, it's called the EL100 RG Micro.
Mm-hmm.
It's literally a 100 milliwatt red and green star cluster.
You know,
you might have seen this sort of effect before, but it's just a great little unit in the starting price of LaserWorld's massive range of lasers.
Yeah, and it's relatively simple to use, isn't it?
You've just
got a couple of dials on the back.
You've got a speed control where you can actually slow down the actual movement of the laser.
Yep.
So actually just a twinkle effect where it's still, to speeding it up to the speed that you want. And then you've got sound to light functions on the back. You've then got sound to light speed or sort of adjustment controls, a strobe sort of flashing control. So you can sort of alter it to how you want it to work for you. But it's just a little laser. Comes with a little stand, comes with a little L-shaped bracket if you need to hang it.
Mm-hmm.
And as I said, it's like about £69 at most, and online or in stores.
Okay, great for, ideally, someone just starting out mobile work.
Yeah.
Small venues, small bars, pubs.
Absolutely. It's just a little thing, great for home parties, that sort of thing. Especially in small rooms. Lasers, you know, especially on high power units, can be dangerous if used in the wrong way, which we'll come on to later in a video.
Yes.
But with this, it's perfectly safe in the way it's set up. It's because it's in what's called a diffraction lens that's at the front, and literally the laser beam is split up into many different dots, and it means it becomes relatively safe. When I've done tests and measured the actual output beam or the strongest beams, which are the center beams, it's even, you know, safe for me to stand here at this distance and, you know, even be looking towards it. I don't recommend you go right up to the unit and look in towards it.
No.
You wouldn't do that with fire.
No.
Well, you wouldn't do it with laser.
Again, I've always said this, it's never a good idea to look into any laser.
Yeah.
However low the output, just don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't
even
do it.
Light effects, some of the high power LED light effects that you get now. Some of them you can fry an egg from, you know, 2
yeah,
meters away.
I can imagine,
you
know? Yeah.
So it's only like looking at the sun. You wouldn't stare into the sun too long. You wouldn't put your hand into a flame and put your eye over a flame. It's the same for it. It's just being sensible.
Yeah. And also, again, I did say earlier on in this video, it is broad daylight. And it just shows how powerful this kind of low-end product is, because it's cutting through the light. Admittedly, we've got a bit of smoke in the room, but as you can see,
it is broad daylight outside.
I know, look at it!
And it's still bright.
It's still bright. We've still got a good effect, so
when darkness falls, it's going to look
even better. So middle of the summer, if you're doing a wedding, and you're in a room which again is white, and there's the lights are on, and you know, you've got your power bars, and you're wondering, how can I put a good effect on the floor? One of those on a T-bar directed to the dance floor will give quite a nice effect.
Absolutely. And even if you've got something like the stretchy cloths, what are those cloths called?
Oh, Scrim King type effect, yeah, got you.
You put that behind it, up a speaker stand, or behind a deck stand, or something along those lines. It's a great little effect, and because it's so small, it's handy to do that.
All right, what we'll do, we'll pause the camera now and we'll have a bit of a fiddle. What we're going to do is we're going to go through the different lasers. So during the course of this video, we're going to go from those guys up to the bad boys. So we've had a look at that one there. That one looks the same. What's the difference, Dennis?
It's just the diodes that are used inside, so the colours are different. So, as you can see, it's green and blue, as opposed to red and green in the last one. And there's three actually in this range. There's a red and blue unit called an EL200 micro, and this one's an EL150 micro. And you have the red and blue one, which goes out the door online at £99. And then this one is 139. So it's the green and blue diodes, a little bit more expensive together. It's got all the usual features on the actual unit of strobing, like we were shown before in the previous video. It's just the different colours.
Okay.
So as I said, you've got a £99 one, and you've got this one, which is 139. It's the blue diode that's more expensive because you need more power in a blue diode.
Yeah.
To actually see the brightness.
What we were discussing earlier on, we had a bit of a laugh, didn't we, about using these in functions, and they're great for kids to mess around with. Now, first of all, when I say kids to mess around with, I do not, and I reiterate, I do not say children should mess with the laser or have fun with it, but let's say in a mobile environment, you've got one of these low-powered lasers on the floor. Children like to mess around with the dots and chase the dots and whatnot, and it's relatively safe, isn't it? Because again, they are low powered.
Yeah, again, it's because of the diffraction lens. It outputs the laser into multiple beams straight from the start, and it has a lens physically blocking the single beams coming out. So literally diffracts it off, makes it into a safe output level. Again, I did a test on this particular one the other week with a measuring tool, and it's a static beam in the middle that you measure, and it is literally safe from this distance. So these are fine for, you know, bedrooms, that sort of thing. If you want something in the house, parties in the house, etc. They are very safe little units because of the actual output power.
All right. The input power, is it 12 volts?
Yes.
It is, because I've seen on other makes you can get small appliances you can stick into the car. So presumably it's the same with this.
Yeah, you can just get a 12 volt adapter if you want, and then just literally use that to then project the actual laser. You know, you see it in limousines, that sort of thing. Yeah. It's a small little unit.
But just be careful. Don't start sticking it out the window.
You should be driving and
no.
projecting that laser around the car and all this sort of thing. If you're stationary, that's when it should be used.
All right, so we got those two. Which one are we going to look at next? We will pause the camera, but which one next?
Next one, we'll come on to the ES650. That's the professional version of what I've just been showing you.
Okay, fantastic. Here we go, slightly more professional. Let me just turn this tune down a little bit. Okay, my friend, what we got here then, geezer?
This one is a professional star cluster. It's called the ES650 GB. GB standing for green blue, 650 standing for 650 milliwatt. The difference with this unit is it's a lot wider spread. It's brighter.
A lot brighter, yeah.
And this unit will literally fill a big venue with one effect. So if you want one effect that will just fill a room completely, this is the one for you. It's got a beautiful blue, really nice piercing blue. green, it will flip between different patterns over a period of time. It has a star cluster effect, the fraction thing with the dots, and also it has what I call like a firework effect, where it sort of gives up like lines.
Yeah.
But you'll notice that the spread is very wide.
Yes, let's have a look. If again, you can see that laser is in exactly the same position as the others, and that's filling
literally the whole back.
Yeah, it is, even to the over there. It's getting over there.
You'll notice it literally projects at a very wide angle.
Yeah.
So it literally fills the venue, whether it's small or large, you'll have a big coverage over the actual venue.
Okay, I talked earlier on with the last one about people potentially looking into the beam. Are we going to have adverse effects if people start looking and staring into the beams of this one?
I mean, again, with this unit, it's a safer way, it's the safest way of projecting the laser because of the diffraction lens, because it's literally splitting it from source.
Yes.
So you have no risk of any single beams in any way, shape or form coming out from the aperture.
Got you.
So with this unit, yes, you have to, you wouldn't really be buying this for a bedroom or a party at home, because this is a more professional unit and a proper case with where you can rack it up onto trussing. It's DMX capable, with actually on the back of the unit, so you can actually control the effects and the speed of the unit from a DMX desk.
Yeah.
Simple operation. But you would potentially have this up on the rig, and maybe this core central 10 beams you'd point above people's heads.
Got you.
Which are the strongest beams.
Yes.
Keep it at a distance of 2 to 3 meters high.
Yeah.
As you would on a T-bar stand or a goalpost. And that will then literally, if you give us 4 to 10 central beams out of the way of people's reach, you're going to keep things safe. The peripheral beams on the outer edges can fill the rest of the room and it still looks fantastic.
Mm. I can see this. Again, the unit itself is, I would say, 7 or 8 meters from the wall, and I could imagine if that was in a room, say, I don't know, something 20 or 30 meters, I mean, it would fill the place completely, wouldn't it?
It fills a small room, it's with the extra power. You don't just get extra brightness, you get with a higher power laser, it's not just that brightness that you see initially, it's the power and the distance that they actually travel. So the bigger venue, you will actually notice that the power will still be the same output at maybe the end of a 500 capacity venue as it would be a 50 capacity venue
with
this sort of unit.
By the way, just to let you know as well, the tune you're listening to is by a lady called Coley. I'll put a link in the description. All right, geezer, we like that one. And we are, during the course of this video, going through. So we're almost going through, and again, it's not cheap and cheerful. It's sort of the lower end price bracket into the bad boys, isn't it, really?
A sort of semi-professional sort of range, as we class it.
Yes.
Is what you get with this sort of unit. I mean, this ES 650S is, I think, street price about 329. So around the 300 quid mark, you'll see this unit for sale. But as I said, it's one laser will fill the venue rather than having two separate effects. So three separate effects are, £100 a piece or
£150 a piece. Something very important as well I need to stress. We are now in August 2012, so the prices that Dennis is giving could fluctuate depending on when you do watch this video. Could increase or could decrease, just bear that in mind.
Yeah.
What are we looking at here then, geezer?
Right, well, this is where you're moving into LaserWorld's big territory, in the sense that it's a beam effect laser. So what you're looking at here is a unit called the EL350RG. And it's a red-green 350 mW laser. But as you can see, it's a four-head laser. Two red outputs, two green outputs. So effectively on the rig in the dark, from a distance, it looks like you've got four lasers built into one unit. But it's just a very well-priced unit. It's nice, high output power for the price of it. It's around £200 street. So it's actually, I think, very good value for such a...
£200? Right, that's
four,
pretty good.
Four-head laser, I think it's very good. This is a brand, it's a new unit. As I said, it's called the EL350. And if you're just looking for something that's got bright output power with a bit of haze and smoke in the room, you want that sort of
classic laser effect.
I was going to say, it's ravey. This reminds me of, you know, 90s rave style lasers, just big, in your face. Yeah,
absolutely.
So, that is cool.
You know,
like,
you see your dance events, that sort of thing, dance gigs, and you want something you do, you know, teenagers' parties, 18s, 21st, that sort of thing. It'd be a great little piece of kit for you.
All right, and again, relatively simple.
Yeah.
We've got DMX and sound to light.
Yeah, if you flick dip switch number one down, 10 is on, one down is sound to light, and now you can see it's gone off because it's not hit anything, but as I tap it,
yeah,
it'll then pick up on a bass beat effectively and then start going in time with the music.
Great. So again, someone who just wants plug and play, very simplistic.
Yeah, absolutely. That's how it's made, nice and easy. There's no complex
that
are not required at this sort of level.
Yeah. Sweet. All right, and just mention again, because I was right by the speaker then, the model number of this guy.
It's an EL350RG.
All right, what I will do, I'll put hyperlink to the LaserWorld website in the description so you can go and check that one out. Nice one. Right, tune you're listening to in the background, by the way, is by Enzyme Black, track entitled Take It. And we've got this one here, sir.
Right, this is the ELD800RB. 800 milliwatt red and blue laser, but not just red and blue, it's also purple. It combines the red and the blue dye to produce a nice bright purple, which, as far as I've seen in this sort of price bracket, is unique, because most purples out there using the violet diode is very faint. You can't, it's really not visible to the eye. So people like the color purple, but it's not bright enough. This unit, it's very bright. It's got a nice, powerful blue diode and red diode to produce the combination of a nice, beautiful purple. Again, it's a simple unit. It's got a double aperture, so it's got two outputs. It looks like a twin laser, or two lasers from a distance working together in sync. Really does look like two lasers from a distance. It's a very simple unit in the sense that it's got the usual features as for the previous effect. It's got DMX, it's got the same functionality on the DMX switching. If you switch down the number one, it's down sound to light. So we're going time with the music, we have it loud. Otherwise you just switch this, switch number one up, and you're back onto auto, and 10 up is on. And it's just a nice, I think, bright laser that's been very popular. People do love this effect, so it's definitely worth going to see in one of your local stores. By the way, it's worth mentioning that, you know, now LaserWorld is now, only until recently this year, it's never been really available directly within the UK. Now there's a direct distribution in the UK office, and you can literally purchase from any of the sort of online or local, a lot of local retailers. So do check out your local retailer, see if they have, you know, in stock. If not, you'll be able to find it in online, or you can also contact us at the LaserWorld UK office.
Yeah.
And you will then basically be directed to where you can actually view any of these units you've been seeing.
Okay, sounds good.
Look, the good thing about having the UK office as well is you've got, you know,
you speak to someone in the UK.
Yeah.
Don't you? You don't speak to someone halfway around the world. It's nice to speak.
English.
Yes. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. No disrespect, of course, to people who are halfway around the world, because you would be saying the same thing if you were halfway around the world and you had to speak to someone in bloody England.
Absolutely.
Isn't it? Absolutely. Yeah. All right. Stepper motors in there. What sort of speed are we looking at?
I think on those units, in this particular unit, just let me check, because we have got the biggest range of lasers in the world.
Yeah, so I got you there, didn't I?
You can't know every specification off the top of your head, but it's a 2-5 kpps, basically.
Okay.
2-5k motor. So the motors are relatively, sort of the lower end in the LaserWorld range.
Yeah.
What we do is produce a high output laser, so you get a lot of power.
They are bright.
Yeah. Very bright.
But if you want something with better motors, because you want to do graphics, or smoother, you know, circles, lines, that sort of thing, you start moving up into the ranges we'll show.
We're going to go through, I mean, I'm just thinking out loud here. What we've done is we've done something pretty cool here. Is we've started off with the cheaper range, but what we've done, we've started off with the cheaper range in broad daylight, showing how bright they are in broad daylight. And then we're going through to the more expensive as it gets darker.
Yeah.
If we'd have done it the other way around, then of course the cheaper ones would have been very bright in the dark, and the bright ones would have been very bright in the light. So by, in a way, we've sort of shown how bright the cheaper ones are in the light, and everyone knows that the more expensive ones are going to be bright anyway. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah.
You know.
The bright,
I hope you got that, by the way.
The budget ones would have looked maybe nearly as bright as they did the more professional ones.
Yeah. Well, yeah. We could have quite easily just waited. We could have had a few beers, chilled out, and thought, right, it's pitch black now. Let's show this small, cheap laser in pitch black. Look how bright it is. But what we've done is we've turned the damn things on in broad daylight and gone, that's quite bright, actually, isn't it?
Yeah,
All right.
Oh, this one, the street price on this is about $3.99. I think it's about $3.69.
Yeah.
Around that sort of money. But it's well worth having a look at online prices or in your local store.
Yes.
It's a very impressive laser. You know, when you see a laser in the flesh compared to actually a video, it's 100 times better. It's just
completely different, yeah.
It really captivates the eye.
Fantastic. Okay, we'll pause the camera and we'll have a look at another one. It is starting to get a little bit darker now, so much so I've got a dodgy light on. This guy here, right, before we move on to the next laser, Interlock, can you tell everyone what that is all about?
Right, an Interlock is a safety device. If I actually take that out now, it actually turns off the laser, put it on, it wires on. That's just a standard feature, so when you buy a laser, you can literally activate it straight away. The reason for an Interlock is wiring one of these. This is called an e-stop. An e-stop is basically what's classed as an emergency stop. And what it basically do, you have a cable that comes out of here. If you buy one of these, you get it wired with a cable, with an interlock, so you can connect up to your laser. And this is sort of a UK legislation across the world. It depends on what country you're in. But in the UK, they have an interlock as a legislation. And all it is basically, if you have a unit up in your rig, you can literally stop somebody from using the laser. You can take away the key, it's in the off position, you come back, you put your key on, you switch it on, and then literally you can activate your laser.
Mm-hmm.
But at any one point, you can have a button right in front of you to turn on and off.
Got you.
So it's handy. There's a lot of the time also, it's a handy feature, not just for safety, that sometimes a laser looks better when you've got it coming on maybe every hour for 15 minutes.
Not all the time.
It actually adds more of an impact when you're using your lasers, that you bring them on every so often.
Yes.
Rather than just continually on, which a lot of people do on mobile DJ rigs and things. They just keep the lasers on and off. Better to rotate your effects, keep a bit more interesting.
Mm-hmm.
But it's for also health and safety purposes. If on a laser, this is the idea behind it, if at any one point, because you always should be monitoring what you're doing with lasers, if a single beam was to come out because the scanner's failed, you've had your laser for a few years, literally you notice that single beam comes out, you can hit the stop button and protect people from looking into it.
Yeah.
But with that, I can talk about a few safety features about lasers, what you sort of do.
Go for it.
Might as well talk about it now, since it's always started. So with sort of safety features like this, you have little tips and tricks when you're setting up your laser. Units, generally most lasers that are sort of purchased are class 3B or class 4 in the entertainment industry.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, anything below a 500 milliwatt is class 3B up until a certain point. There's lower classes for CD players, etc., and where all lasers are, you know, used in many different functions.
Mm-hmm.
So most effect lasers for entertainment purposes are class 3B. If it's over 500 milliwatts, class 4. Now class 4
is where it can actually be dangerous, if especially used with single beams, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But in the right hands, and if you use it right, you know, right with single beams, on used with software in conjunction, and used with mirror effects, etc., Class 4 can be safe, as long as it's projected above people's head, it's at 3 meters high, as all lasers should be.
Yes.
In legislation, they should be hung at 3 meters high. So on a goalpost stand or something like that, mm-hmm. 3 meters from the actual ground. So if you're on a stage, for example, you mm-hmm. have it from 3 meters from the top of the stage, you can have yep. it from 3 meters from the ground.
Right.
And that means that it's without out of distance for people sticking their hands in the way, people actually, more importantly, putting their face in the way of the
yeah.
laser, and at close proximity. And if you just sort of follow these simple sort of guidelines, it means that you're sort of just being sensible, using common sense,
yep.
you know, when you're actually using lasers in a show sort of scenario. And then, you know, if you've got it 3 meters high, you then maybe project it forward. But if you have no control through software, which I'll explain with software later, we're using Pangolin tonight, we've used Phoenix before in demonstration videos at Jonathan. But we'll show you how you set up safety zones.
Mm-hmm.
So lasers software is not just for good for effects, it's also good for setting up your laser and getting the most out of your laser and projecting the laser in the right direction.
Fantastic.
Well, if you don't have the benefit of software, you'd literally have that 3 meters high, project it above people's heads, and maybe fire it towards the roof, especially if it's a class 4 laser.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's where you think it's at a safe distance, maybe sort of 10 to 15 meters for something around the 500 milliwatt mark to a 1 watt mark,
mm-hmm.
You could literally project it sort of point it down towards the back of the room at about 15 meters.
Okay.
As long as you're not doing single beams, etc., and things like that. As long as it's a, you know, an animation like we're seeing now with shapes and stretched images.
Yeah, this guy, what are we looking at? What's the name of this
right,
one?
This one is called a ES 800 RGB. It's an 800 milliwatt red, green, blue laser. The red, green, blue actually mixes up to produce 7 different colours. So it's a colour laser.
White as well, I presume.
Yeah, you'll get a white sort of mix in certain animations, and you get what I feel with this unit, a light electric blue. It mixes the three diodes beautifully, so you bring a nice electric blue, beautiful yellows, etc. But I feel it's really a great colour laser at a fantastic price. It's about £450 street price. It's 800 milliwatt, it's a colour laser. There's not many units out there at that sort of money for a colour laser.
Fedders.
You know, people have seen sort of blue lasers over the past few years and that sort of thing as the blue diode price came down. And now it's sort of moving towards people wanting colour lasers to keep, you know, something new and ahead of the, you know, the competition as such as being a DJ out there.
Mm-hmm. All right, fantastic. So we'll pause the camera here and we'll have a look at another one. Now, I do like the look of that. We've gone from what I would class as flashy, scribbly kind of in-your-face lasers to something that's it's got a bit of chic about it. There's nice, smooth movements.
Yeah.
What are we dealing with here, Dennis?
Okay, we'll start now to get into a more professional range. One thing I made a mistake with today, I should have brought one of the Club Series and I left it at home. So
are they the really expensive ones?
No, the Club Series is the what we class as the semi-professional range.
So okay.
Units like a CS1000 RGB, 2000
yep.
RGB, 1 watt. It's like high power,
yes.
good scanners,
yep.
affordable sort of units.
Okay.
For example, you could pick up a CS1000 or 1 watt laser, full colour laser,
mm-hmm.
For about... I think it's $799 street price, so it's
yeah.
like affordable, you know, colour laser. And you can actually pick up a, you know, this up with Phoenix software, for example, for about £1,100, or with Pangolin software for about £1,200 as a package with a 1 watt laser. So I did make the mistake of not bringing that, but you can always go to the LaserWorld website, punch in you know, CS1000 RGB, or go and select that product and you'll have a look at the video. It's well worth it. It's if you want to get into a laser with a bit more scanning control and power and
mm-hmm.
connecting with software through an ILBA cable, it's a great way to start. It really is.
I mean, what we have here...
That is cutting through the light, isn't it? Big time.
This is a 1.8 watt laser. This is our PM1800 RGB in the pure micro range. And it's a tiny little box, as you can see.
It's tiny.
Oh, this is how small it is.
That is so tiny. That makes small look insignificant.
It's amazing, really. A year ago, I was carting around flight cases this size, and with units that weren't even as good quality in the beam or the brightness.
Mm-hmm.
And what LaserWorld have done in the Swiss last range, this is made in Switzerland. It's the components in Switzerland, our own diodes, where we manufacture them, and our own Swiss last diodes. And literally, we've brought down this unit, big units, into a tiny little unit. I think in the previous video, Jonathan took the lid off, I noticed, and showed inside, which was fantastic.
I know, and the components are so small, aren't they? Flipping it, amazing.
But the great thing about that as well, it's not just it's just small in size. It means that there's no inertia on big components. When you've got a big component and it gets knocked around in the back of a boot of a car or in a van and that sort of thing, you have a tendency for the components to move.
Yes.
And with lasers, when you've got three diodes and RGB diodes all pointing towards one mirror, a slight bit of knock and something moves, you're going to lose color balance, you're going to lose output power.
Never thought of that. Yeah, good point.
So the good thing with these little units is I've never, in any of the units that I've had, which we use as part of our rental stocks, we actually have a rental thing where people rent them for the weekend for events, different things, but they've maybe got a special event on. Since starting in March with these, never had one to realign. Now, old units with big diodes and everything like that, I would have had to go in there and actually change the actual alignment. Obviously, I've been trained in how to do that.
Yes.
I would recommend doing that, and only without
don't open it. I said, don't open your lasers.
Your warranty.
No, exactly. You will, spend £1,000 on a laser, open it up and have a fiddle.
No.
Tough. It's worth nothing. No, don't do it.
Don't do it. So bring it into a service centre, contact LaserWorld if you feel you have a problem or anything like that. You're using the unit's taking a knock, you feel that you've seen the colour diodes just not quite aligning next to each other, and you'll see maybe a red or a green or a blue, just not lines going by the side of each other. It means your diodes are out of alignment as such.
All right, well, I'm going to just zip under there.
Yeah.
Thank you. Let's have a look at this software then. If you could...
Yeah.
Maybe show us this software. And this software, once again, is called?
This one's called Pangolin. Pangolin is really the biggest, most famous laser software package in the world. This is their quick show version, which is their budget range. And it's, you can probably see from the screen, it's very simple.
Yep.
You've got literally animations to hover over. So if I click, it will project that particular animation.
Straight away, like
straight
it.
Away. So you've literally got over 1,000, I think it's even more, I'd have to check how many animations are in there. It could be a lot more, literally at your fingertips. So as I'm just clicking
very
down,
nice.
It projects. And it actually morphs the image into the next one, which I think is quite
that
nice.
Is very, very smooth. I do like that. Very
so
much so. Can you take it from that, say, to an animal or a bird or something like that?
So if I go into the graphics tab and then I hit baseball player.
Yeah.
So, and then you'll get...
Sweet. There's so much more of a difference between it, as you say, you know, this slight transformation and morphing from one to the other, instead of a, you know, you have, for example, all right, you've got the runner, and then you've got this big flash, and it goes into another effect.
Yeah. I mean, you can change that transition, so it flicks instantly. If that suits what you're doing, maybe with beam effects to flip back and forth between beam effects, you know, on the beat of the music or anything like that. But literally, you can flick instantly, or you can go back to that transition thing like we were showing before.
Mm-hmm.
But with the Pangolin software, it's nicely set up. You've got tabs across the top where it said graphics, atmospherics, all pages, so it shows all the different tabs. And then, so if we click on graphics, you've got things like backgrounds. So you've got sort of animation stuff that will just stick in the background. You've got people and characters. So you've got loads of different sort of animations as such. So if you look towards the wall now, there's some
sort of all sorts of animations. And this is a great thing for mobile DJs as well. A lot of mobile DJs sort of say that where they can't use smoke in a venue, certain venues have restrictions on that, a lot of hotels do, but when they have software at your hands, literally you can get your laser to work for you. You've got animations at your fingertips, all different sorts of things.
And also, again, you can, for example, someone comes along, you know, happy birthday to Dorothy, or happy birthday to Fred.
Yeah.
You can type it in, can't you?
If you look down in the bottom left-hand corner here, it says quick text. So literally you can click on quick text. I have LaserWorld typed in there.
If I turn that animation that was on before, go back to quick text, and I'm just literally typing now,
happy birthday
and then show it now. As quick as that.
Yeah. And that is great for a mobile DJ who, oh, thank you very much, who and you spelled my name correctly as well.
Did I?
Yeah. Oh. Johnathan. Yeah, well done. That's great for DJs. I mean, no, you haven't spelled it. J-O-N. It's J-O-H-N, never mind.
Oh, sorry.
I only saw the last bit of it. No, but so many times you get, I mean, you know this, anyone who's watching this now, if you are a mobile DJ, how many times have we had people come up to us and go, can you say happy birthday to whoever? And you go, yes, fine, I will. And they stand in front of you and they want you to say happy birthday now. You know, not like in 5 minutes' time when you're ready to do it because you're, you know, you actually have to do other things. Something like this, I suppose you could, really. You could just, yeah, all right, fine, type it in. And instead of saying happy birthday, you go, well, guess what? How about having it on a laser instead?
Yes.
And from my professional opinion tells me that people would far prefer to see it in a laser or laser form as opposed to you just saying it on a microwave. My microwave! Microphone! Bloody hell! Microwave! Oh dear! I'm not going to edit this, I'm just going to leave that in. Oh, that is so funny. Oh dear.
I tell you what though, a lot of mobile DJs tell me when I've
microwave! Oh, I'm not going to live that one down. Can we put it at medium power, please? Oh dear. Microwave. Oh, there you go, see? That's how quick it is.
But what a lot of mobile DJs have told me what they've been doing with this when they've purchased, they've actually been adding it as an extra service. So, you know, you go to a wedding, they can actually say, would you like the bolt-on package of the laser to text service? You can put your wedding messages and have your name up on a laser up on the wall and lights, and they sort of charge an extra, I don't know, £50, £100.
Can you show me, when you say text, as in, yeah, people on the mobile phones, how would they go about doing
well,
that?
Well, in QuickShow, you can literally type text as such. There is a bolt-on package where it's called SMS to Laser.
Yeah.
And you can purchase the SMS to Laser package once you've got QuickShow.
Mm-hmm.
And the SMS to Laser not just basically enables people to send texts to the PC through a little dongle, phone
Bluetooth?
Dongle. Yeah, like a little Bluetooth or a phone dongle. So,
gotcha.
What you buy for maybe Vodafone, that sort of thing. There is some links on the recommendations on the Pangolin website of what to buy.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's one called Zoom. And you literally, besides being able to take people actually send a text, you put the telephone number up on the wall, people can send text messages in. Rather than just messages, you can actually do voting with it. You can actually have polls of what track would you like next, and literally you'll see a voting poll going up the wall of which track did want to actually play next, or which drink should be a pound a shot.
I like it. Like it.
However you want to be creative with it, it actually takes it to the next level.
Wow.
So it's quite an amazing thing. It's called SMS to Laser. It's quite an amazing piece of kit. But as with QuickShow, as when you purchase this unit,
You've literally got loads of different, as we're showing, sports, vehicles, music and dancers. There's all sort of instruments in there to VU meters, celebration stuff with fireworks, cakes and things for happy, say happy birthday. You've got a little view screen here on the right hand side, which shows you what the actual laser is outputting. If I click off it, it goes off the screen. And then you've got sort of, you know, different themes, you know, Halloween.
Halloween. Brilliant. Big in America.
Big in America. Pangolin's made in America. But you've literally got loads of different sort of animations and stuff for themes. So if it's Halloween, if it's Christmas, if it's New Year, you've got loads of things already pre-built in for your show without you needing. Even stuff for St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, look at that.
So it's all thought
of. Which, St. Patrick's Day, yes, brilliant island. But you know what? If you're in New York, it's just as good. Right, something I want to talk about here is we've got the laser there. And it's pointing in that direction over there. Now let's imagine that, right, we've got the clock. Underneath the clock, we've got the crowd. And we have to have the laser at a certain height above the crowd's heads. But then we would also like to maybe put some sort of image on the wall to the right, or maybe on the wall to the left. And we can have those images slightly higher or lower. So can you explain how we could do that, please, Dennis?
Yeah, it's quite simple. I'll turn that effect off. You literally go into the top tabs across here. You've got file, edit, view, page, settings, as you'd be used to through sort of typical window applications. You've then got projector settings. And then you've got the first tab, which says size and position. Now, what you've got here is a little window that you can then change your projection of your laser within its scan angle. The bigger the scan angle, the more flexibility you've got. But over on the right, it says test pattern and show it now. If I click on that, you'll notice now there is a test pattern on the wall.
Yeah.
Now that then defines the maximum size output that your laser with any animation you select will go within those parameters.
Yeah.
Some bigger, some to that maximum, or some smaller.
Mm-hmm.
I can then grab that box and stretch it and open up. Now you notice with this laser, it's actually got a very wide angle. They actually had it very well produced. And now look at the size of that particular animation.
Yes.
But you go into a big room, you don't want that size of projection.
No.
Because it's going to be too big, it's going to expand through a room and be...
It's all relevant, isn't it? You know, if you've got a very long room, you're going to have it a lot smaller because as it hits the back, it's going to be bigger. Yeah.
What you can do, if you feel that the unit's too powerful for the size of the venue, you can, for example, what I'm doing there, is I could bring the actual X and Y axis nice and big. So I can have the X axis, left and right, basically wide, but then I can project it above people's heads.
Yeah, got you, yeah.
So then if I just go back into a beam effect as such, you will now notice, I'll just go into that nice wide beam effect.
You've got a really big wide beam.
Yes,
that's
like it.
That's never going to go below what we set that parameter at.
Hmm.
So literally people could effectively be reaching for the sky.
But not their heads.
But not their heads.
Yeah.
So that it's safe. And you have beautiful bright beams above people's heads like that. It's very impressive. And you know, when it comes to sort of dance events or anything like that, people want to be able to touch that beam, the laser beam. They love that, that sort of effect. So anything you then select is always going to be above the head. So it means it's nice, it's safe. It also doesn't annoy a lot of people and scanning in the face all night. And then everything you do is all preset.
Yeah, like it.
Well, if we go back to those settings, you've then got things like X and Y axis. So if we just reduce that again in size so it's legible up on where we're projecting, show it now. You'll notice that projection says top. You can invert it. So you can change it to a different sort of position, then put it the way you want it. You can reverse it so you can project onto screens or ball screens, etc., so you can reverse an image. You can reverse the X and Y image, or the Y projection, if you effectively
had it maybe mounted on top of a T-bar stand, on top of a stand, upside down, you can just reverse your image, so everything projects the correct way.
It's like you said earlier, sorry, you had it projecting on the ceiling, and you had the wording, so anyone that was in this position, if I'm over here now, and I'm looking at the ceiling, they could see the wording, and you had the wording come across, didn't you?
So you could have it in some sort of way. You can invert it in the way you want to see it.
Yeah.
Is that correct for you?
No. That's it, that'll do. Nope. That'll do.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
So effectively, you could set up different projection zones. You could have, if your laser's within its scan angle, you can have it maybe mounted up sort of to a decent level.
Yeah.
You could have it projected towards the ceiling or a side wall with projecting the graphics.
Mm-hmm.
You can then set up a different projection zone for your beam effects.
Yeah.
As in the squares and the shapes and stuff that you want to sort of point above people's heads or to scan the audience if it's at a safe level. So you can set up different zones. So people can actually see the text legible in front of them without turning around to the back of the venue and seeing what they're sort of writing on the wall.
Yeah.
And that's what the laser software sort of enables. It gives you the tool to basically make the laser work for you and make it easy for you in looking very professional in what you're doing.
Fantastic. Right, here we go. I've got my my helper, Mr. Moo, Blaze. Say hello, Blaze. All right, Dennis, what are we going to look at now, sir?
Right. Going back to we were talking about projection settings before, there's a few couple of other features that are nice to show you. Within here, you're showing where you can actually move the projection zone.
Mm-hmm.
But what you can actually go into is different patterns. So you can set up different zones. Mm-hmm. So it says zone 1, zone 5. The zone 2, 3 and 4, maybe if you have a second projector connected, the only way of controlling those individually is having a second pangolin box.
Yeah.
But in zone 5, you could have your secondary graphics. So maybe you could move your secondary graphics over here for zone 5. That could be your animations that you define. So, you know, it could be some birthday messages, your text and that sort of thing over to the left. And then in zone 1, you could have your actual beam effects going straight forward.
You can't have a go, you're too young. Maybe when you're two. Okay?
Yeah, you tell him.
But another great feature, I feel, if you go into settings and you go into projection zones, so there you can also do more settings, more in-depth settings for your projection zones. You can change the geometric correction. That means it sort of changes the shape of how it's projecting on a wall.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're going to a side wall, you can make it look like it's projecting flush and straight on.
Ah, very good.
So it's
like
a nice
it.
Little feature.
Yes.
But a great feature that I do love, Phoenix also has this sort of feature, but the great thing about the pangolin variation is you can say we go into scanner 1,
boy,
we can project a zone there as we're doing.
Yeah.
You can then hit on enable beam attenuation.
Right, let me just go, I'm going to try and
flip
from
back to there. You've got a load of different percentages. You can literally present down to 0%, 10% within animation. So if you want to project beams to an audience but you feel it's going to be safe if you project the bottom half at less power. Now, if you notice, if I either flip back, suddenly that is a lot less output power.
Gotcha.
But what you can do is do different things. So you can literally mask off different areas. You notice there that it's all literally fading away as I mask off areas. So literally with that area there,
you can do the bottom half at low power. So effectively, people are still getting engulfed by tunnels, that sort of thing, which they love to be in.
Yeah, but they can't burn their retinas out.
But it's at a safe projection. When you
set up correctly, it's at a safe projection. So you've got to be careful, you know, what you're projecting and what power. You've got to be sensible with it.
Yes.
But this gives you the power to enable you to do that.
you can also, maybe if you are doing something more professional for like television work, etc.
Yep.
Or where you know there's cameras within a venue.
Yes.
So maybe there's some security venue. The cameras can be damaged by laser projections if it, you know, certain single beams or high power output beams go across a lens. If it hits it at the right angle, it can literally take out a pixel.
Mm-hmm.
But what you can do is, if you know where the camera is and you've got your laser in position, you can literally draw a little sort of area. So you can maybe go, okay, I want to reduce that area to 10%, and literally you just literally draw a sort of little area that then, get it right,
yeah,
that basically cuts out that camera, so you don't cause yes. any damages to the camera as such.
Yeah.
So.
Or if you don't like the cameraman, you can give him 100%. So. Right, I'm going to have to pause this because we've got 5 minutes left on the battery, so I need to charge this sucker up, okay? Here we go. We have two of the PM series. The one on the right is the 1800. The one on the left is the 1300. Dennis, it's over to you.
Yeah, as you notice, there's a slight bit of difference. You'll never get a vast difference. You know, for example, if a unit's a 1 watt laser and then there's a 2 watt laser, 1,000 milliwatt, 2,000 milliwatt, you'll never get a doubling of the power.
Mm-hmm.
You'll always get it where it's maybe 20 to 25% brighter. But what you will notice over a bigger room and a bigger distance, you'll notice a higher amount of output from the 2 watt version compared to a 1 watt version.
Yeah.
The higher power not just is a slight bit of difference in the brightness when you see it in a small room, it travels a further distance. So that's
yes.
something to remember. If you go to see a unit in a demo room, in a small demo room or something sort of this size, you won't notice much difference. Put it into a bigger venue, you'll notice a lot of difference.
Mm.
So, but while we've sort of connected these up, you'll see that these two lasers are really working like pair of scanners looking at, you know,
absolutely beautiful,
you know. And this is something that a lot of people don't realize. They have these things called ILVA connectors on the back, and they have this little unit here. It's like a cable.
I just put the light on. We've got a little light above.
So a lot of people will probably have a connector on the back that they've never known what actually it is on the back of the laser.
ILDA, isn't it?
And it's yeah. ILDA, International Laser Display Association is what it stands for. It's the standard connection for lasers.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's 21 pins in total that you can, and they all have a function. And what it does from software, for example, it enables you to select many different effects and have control over your lasers.
Could you very quickly earlier on, we weren't recording, you explained why we've got 1, 2, 3, so
right.
Go for it.
With these pure micro range, this is for what they call the Swiss Lass range, and this is an interlock connector. And what you have with this, rather than having a interlock connector that you have to buy a big long cable,
mm-hmm.
as we were explaining earlier with a e-stop, a safety device,
mm-hmm.
with this unit, you can buy the interlock adapter with the actual laser.
Mm-hmm.
And what it does, off technically speaking, pins 4 and 17 from the actual connector, you literally have an e-stop connection at the source. So basically where your software is, right next to it, you have your e-stop. Rather than having to run an independent cable, you can just run one ILDA cable to your laser,
mm-hmm.
and then link to your second laser like we've done here,
yep.
without the need of multiple interlock connectors and cables.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a great little device to buy. It's called the Swiss Lass interlock connector, or you can buy this for, you know, any laser really,
mm-hmm.
That you have, and it you, makes it nice and simple and easy to control your lasers and have them safely in use.
So of course, if for example all of a sudden one of the lasers stops working or some
the
fault
failing,
hit
lasers,
it hit that and it doesn't matter which one,
they'll all stop.
That is the important part.
You have an on off button to instantly turn on and off if you don't have maybe control over your lasers from software. So it's really is a nice little feature.
Well, cool.
You'll notice, shall I pick up the light switch again?
It's right at the top, you got it.
There we go. And then if I flip
right. I'll try and stay over here out of the way.
Well, you notice that everything then you do with your software is all copied. So if
yep.
you already have some lasers with interlock connectors on, you might have a couple, you didn't realize you didn't really make use of them. By buying
laser software, suddenly you can get your lasers working for you. You can make a laser show that looks professionally done, and all you're doing is flicking a few switches.
Yeah.
Literally click and they both sync in. You can create what's called a timeline for your software. You can just sync a load of animations together, press play, and they'll run through a sequence of animations all in time.
Lee Mills, by the way, if you're watching this, Lee, you have got a couple of lasers, and I suggest you go and get some sort of software and the older cables, because you can transform your laser show into something rather special, my friend. We have been having a little sip of this stuff here. Go and check it out. If you like cider. Right, you'll notice that there is the 1300, and that there is rather big. But as Dennis was saying earlier on, something of this power now, maybe even 1-2 years ago, it would have been the size of a small suitcase, and now we're dealing with an item that's I would say you could put 4 CDs on the top. In fact, we'll do that right now.
That's the size of my hand.
Yeah, there's the size of the hand. 4 CDs on the top.
Here you go. Here's an A4 brochure.
Right. Okay. And let's see how powerful this little beauty is. I'll just pause the camera. Right, what we're looking at here, ladies and gentlemen, is the bad boy. But I need to explain that it's not the bad boy where LaserWorld is concerned, because they do even better lasers. More expensive, better quality, more power output, etc. But this in itself is a little bit... Alright, let me explain. That guy there... That is the 1300. That's mine. It's a PM1300. Let's say this is a Mini. And that one there is the Ferrari. So, Dennis, we've got a Ferrari here. Tell us a little bit more about it.
This unit's the PS9200 RGB. It's roughly a 9-watt laser.
Wow.
Basically, RGB, colour laser. It's quite remarkable that it's a 9-watt laser in such a size case. As again, as I was explaining earlier, I was carrying around flight cases to get something that was not even as good quality beams as this. Not as good brightness, not even as good colours. It was 4 times the size, 5 times the size.
Yeah,
quite a remarkable breakthrough in technology.
I'll stop you there for a second. Right, notice that window. We are doing this video footage the same day. Admittedly, the clips, you know, we've got like 5, sometimes 10 minutes in between a clip. Sometimes we've got maybe 20 minutes, but it's the same day, and you'll notice now it's dark. So this particular laser is, it's lighting up the room, isn't it?
Yeah, it absolutely is illuminating the room. Now you're probably wondering, why do you need that sort of power? The other ones would have been justified. But when you come to sort of big events, stadium events, where there's now big LED screens, LED screens are very bright these days. They literally illuminate a place. And for a laser to cut through that, you need higher output power. Mm-hmm. So you then your 1.8 or your 1.3 watt laser look very bright in a 500 capacity, 1000 watt capacity venue.
Yes.
You've got a big LED screen in there, big LED wall that's basically going into clubs. Your laser is going to be drowned out from it in brightness. Mm-hmm. That's why you need a higher output laser. So you probably think it's maybe sometimes, oh, what's the need for that? But that's one of the reasons. Other reasons are, you even this, when it comes to outdoor purposes, in such effects, unless it's very tight single beams or hot beams, etc. Hot beam is what's classed as this sort of thing.
Yeah.
Now that you will notice outside, and you'll get a great effect from it. But even on output for lasers, the reason why you need big output, in the region of 22 watt you need outside for it to be visible with animation effects. The reason for that, you don't have the benefit of haze and smoke.
Very true, yes.
You know, weather conditions, if it was no wind and you had a big strong haze of great, or if it was fireworks night and there was no wind, and it'd be brilliant. But in the real world, you can't predict that and you don't know. So that's why with a high output laser, and you see it concerts, it actually it's actually bright enough on its own to actually pick through the actual air and the molecules in the air and it actually picks up on the dust particles, etc. And that's where you then don't need the benefit of smoke. If you have smoke, you have probably, it looks even better.
Yeah.
You can't rely on that in outdoor scenarios.
I've got to say this, interject slightly, 9 watts. I can remember helping out with rave nights in the early 90s, and I can remember this guy turning up with, you know, a 3 watt laser and it having to be water cooled.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, 3 watts, and that is 9 watts. And also this, the, you know, his was, I don't know, like 5, 6, 7 times bigger. There were pipes all over the place. And
big long sort of,
I know, crazy.
From the wall to here, you know,
silly.
Like 3 meters long. You'd have to have water cooling.
Yeah,
from the
it was water cooled, 3 watts.
Yeah, and there's water pumped through the laser to keep it cool. And
yes.
And then you'd, that was obviously an added cost. You'd have 3-phase power. The amount of power they consume is just ridiculous.
Yeah.
So actually, to run a laser back in the, you know, the 90s and stuff with the water cooled lasers was very expensive. Not mind buying it, very expensive, but to run it was very expensive. So now, with the new technology, we brought the size down. It runs off low voltage. It's quite amazing, really, in what you can actually do.
Yes. You'll notice 24 volts.
24 volts.
Wow.
So effectively,
24 volts when it was 3-phase.
Power convert. You can stick it on the back of the car and project it onto a building.
Don't tell people that.
Advertising.
So you could literally take that, you know, in your truck. And
project it onto a building.
That is mental.
Charge somebody a ridiculous amount of money for
that is mental.
Project their logos.
Yeah, I like that. You know, you could go out into the middle of a desert, you know, with your truck, and you could say, "All right, guys, listen to my hi-fi," and they'd go, "Yeah, right, that's a great hi-fi. Yeah, I've got, you know, my hi-fi in my car is so much louder." And then you could say, "Well, let me just open this small suitcase." You open a small suitcase and you bring this guy out and you say, "Well, yeah, but have you got a laser show like this?" And you've got your software there on your laptop and away you go. Oh, love it, love it.
Absolutely. So you could just project an image like that up on a wall.
Wow.
Change the size of it, project it outside, advertise your club, advertise your promotion. Advertise whatever you want. You can, in the software, you can literally import images, and it draws the vector path for you, what's called the dot to dot. It literally draws the image for you and you can project it. It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
So there's all sorts of things to be able to do with your laser, but this, you know, laser is just a fantastic piece of kit, and it's something you'll start seeing now at sort of larger events and venues across the country.
Small point here, Dennis. Earlier on, with the other lasers, even though they're very good, you hopefully would have noticed on the odd occasion it went blurry and I had to move the camera, the iris, back and forwards to, well, basically just to focus it back so we could see what we were looking at. With this one, I don't have to do it because the laser is so bright, there is enough light in the room, so I don't have to do that at all. And knowing my luck, it'll... Oh, that's Blaze. Yeah, if you can hear Blaze crying in the background, it's because there is so much going on here. I bet you, he doesn't want to go to sleep yet because he knows there's stuff going on in here, bless him. Yeah, he does. He loves fiddly bits, just like my oldest son. Dab dabs, you know, daddy dab dabs. Anything with buttons or pressing or knobs or lights or... It's called dab dabs. He loves pressing and,
I mean... He wants to practice and enjoy.
He wants to practice and enjoy. He does. Yvette?
Yes?
Is he up for coming back in here for a bit?
He's having major, major practice.
Because, he's probably because he wants to come back in here.
No, he's too tired to come back. It's bedtime.
Oh, bedtime. Right. Mum says bedtime. That's it, bedtime. But it is. It's because he probably... just that he knows. I mean, he's only 10 months old. He knows something's going on. So that is sweet. That is very sweet. Wow. Right, there you go. Now I'm starting to move it in and out, totally contradicting what I said earlier on. Actually, that probably could be because the laser light went on and off. So, of course, when it goes off, it's pitch black. And when it turns on, then the camera itself has got to then readjust to the light. There you go. That's my excuse for you. All right. So we've had here a rather nice selection of lasers. And the beauty about the selection here is that we've gone from something that is relatively inexpensive, around about the £70 or £80 mark, 80-90 euros, up to something that's how much is this one again?
I think it's about 14 grand.
£14,000. Oh my frigging goodness.
But it really shows you, you know, we have units that are even more expensive than this.
Dennis, are you insured?
Yes.
You are. Good.
Fight me for it.
Yeah, but you were, yeah, exactly. I was saying earlier on. All right, what is the most expensive laser LaserWorld sell? What sort of price?
The unit in sort of retail terms is about, I think in the region of 200 grand.
Oh my god.
That's a 60 watt RGB.
Wow.
It's concert material, things where you want to project across cities, etc. But I mean, you know, it's all got functions, they've got particular reasons. But the great thing about what you'll notice from me showing you this range, LaserWorld are experts in lasers.
Yes.
So the ideas and thoughts and the designs that go into the units that are made in Germany and Switzerland, transpired through the range, the budget ranges that bring affordable prices and units, but you know, the same thought process goes into the unit, the same quality control goes into the unit. Every unit is tested in Switzerland before dispatch, so you know
that's important.
Yeah,
that is very important.
It's been tested and tried and worked by our Swiss engineers.
Okay.
So it's, you know, the quality control is the highest. I don't know any other brands that in the laser world are actually test in Switzerland and do QC or test in Europe as such before they actually sell the laser. So even from the smallest lasers, you know you're going to be getting the correct output, movement, reliability.
Fantastic. All right, well, Dennis, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And once again, if you want any more info on the lasers you can see and also the software, I will put proper hyperlinks in the description, and Dennis will finish off with
practice and enjoy.
Love you, mate. Nice one.
Love you.